This is Jaime with All Access Elite Boxing. I'm here with Robert Garcia, live from Dallas, Texas. How you doing, Robert?
I'm doing good, man. Thanks for having me.
Listen, Robert, you're known to train some of the best fighters in the world. You have tons and tons of prospects, some that are even from the city of Dallas, out of Grand Prairie, Texas, to be exact. Virgil Ortiz, man, give us your thoughts on Virgil. How is camp going? I heard he's going to be fighting on the undercard of Canelo. Talk a little bit about that.
Yes, Virgil will be on the Canelo undercard, and he's already in training. He's already been in training camp for like 3 weeks. He's a very dedicated kid. As you guys know, he's dedicated. He's got so much talent. Already ranked number 9 in the world. So we're looking to maybe getting a title shot before the end of the year.
Because I know that Virgil obviously fights on DAZN. Golden Boy struck a deal with Eddie Hearn. Eddie Hearn has a lot of his fighters. Last time when ESPN came here to Dallas, Chris Algieri was down here. I know they were looking into possibly making a fight between Chris Algieri and Maurice Hooker, but, Virgil Ortiz is putting his name right there in the mix as well. I mean, a lot of fight fans, know that he brings it. He brings a lot of excitement. He's a showman. He's very respectful, humble young man, and he trains hard. Can you tell a little bit of the fight fans a little bit of insight of his training regimen?
Look, I'm going to tell you about Maurice Hooker. I've never met him, but I've seen his fight when he fought Cholo Salcedo in Oklahoma. And I was impressed, solid kid, very strong, won the fight very, very good, I was very impressed. But look, I have the fighter that's there to challenge him. They're both from the Dallas area. I think that's the fight that needs to happen before the end of the year. Virgil is already ranked number 9 in the world, why choose Chris Algieri? Why, man, there's one in your hometown. You guys could fight, at a local stadium, and I'm sure you guys are going to do really good. So don't go look for anybody else. You guys got to fight my fighter, Virgil Ortiz.
I know he's mentioned that he's looking to hopefully get a title shot by the end of the year, but he's also a pretty big 140-pounder. I believe he makes weight pretty easily, but he's also looking into moving up potentially, even possibly, at welterweight. How soon do you foresee that happening?
Look, he is a big boy. He could make 140 without a problem, but we are looking to moving him up after he gets a title shot. That's what we're pushing for, the title this year, and then making him move to welterweight after that.
What would you say separates Virgil from a lot of these other contenders?
Look, Virgil is one of those kids that is always in the gym. You don't have to worry about him. He starts training, and when he starts, he gives his best for two and a half hours. Doesn't take breaks. He doesn't rest. He's a very dedicated kid. He's always in focus. He's in his room playing instruments, reading a book. That's all he does. He's focused and in his mind, there's only one thing, and that's to become a world champion. That's why he's where he's at right now. He's very dedicated. He's one of the most dedicated kids that I have in my training camp.
How would you rate his power, Robert?
He's got insane power. Obviously, 12 knockouts. That kid hits tremendously hard, and not because I'm his trainer, but in the gym, he shows it with all of my fighters, even with Mikey. He's one that could hang in there with Mikey. Very few could hang with Mikey, Of my other fighters, I can't even put him in against Mikey because Mikey's too much. Virgil's one that could hang in there with Mikey.
Listen, Robert, we always appreciate your time, man. Again, it's fight week. It's Jimmy Blue, All Access Elite Boxing, with one of the best trainers in the world, Robert Garcia.
Thank you very much.